Hey, what's going on, BookTube on YouTube? Today I'm actually doing the mid-year freakout. Stick around. You consider yourself a bookworm, book lover, book addict, book geek, any of those bookish terms? Feed your need now by subscribing for more bookish videos. So in this video, I was actually tagged by Libri Labra, my homegirl, love you girl. And I got really excited because I haven't done a tag video in quite some time. And I figured, you know what, why not do this one? My homegirl tagged me and it looked like a lot of fun. So I said, why not? This is one of those book tags that actually make you really have to dig in, do your homework, do your research, all that stuff. And I actually love book tags like that because they really force you to think and really kind of forces you to think deep down and think about what the answers to those questions are. And I love it. So let's go. Number one is the best book you've read in 2017. And I have to say that it's the book called You, and it's by Carolyn Kepner. It's about this psycho that he is kind of obsessed with one of his customers that he gets. And this guy is so psycho. Things that we just do every day, he actually takes advantage of that. And he just twisted in his mind. For instance, when this girl, she goes and she buys something from the store and uses her debit card, he thinks she's only using her debit card because she wants him to know her name. So yeah, guys, that's the kind of psycho we're working with in that book. The next question is the best sequel I read in 2015. Now, I had to think back because I don't even think I had Goodreads at that time, or I don't even think I logged anything in Goodreads at that time. Who knows? But I can remember being really into Twilight that year, and I read New Moon, so I will have to say that by stuff. Number three is the new release that you haven't read yet, but you want to, and that will have to be Something in the Water by Katherine Stedman. And my homegirl, Shiraldi, has been telling me about this book for the longest time, and I still haven't read it, and even though it's still a new release, I still haven't read it yet. So I'm really gonna dig into that as well, and I can't wait to do it. Number four is the most anticipated release for the second half of the year. And I guess that will have to be I think it's called An Unwanted Guest. And I really don't know really too much about what it is, but it looks like a thriller. Now, I know they say don't judge a book by its cover, but the cover just tells me it's a thriller book, so that's the one I'm gonna go with, because that's kind of looking forward to some action, some scariness, some thriller, some heart pounding kind of stuff. So yeah. Number five is biggest disappointment. I have to say it's Carry On by Rainbow Rowell. And the reason being is because, you know, I started BookTube and I started to go in with an open mind. I already knew right off the bat though that I wasn't interested into any fantasy. I'm not a fantasy person. Like, I don't like fantasy type stuff. But one of the reasons that why I joined you BookTube on YouTube is so that I can be open to those kind of genres and read and learn. And Carry On was my first fantasy book that I read. Really didn't like it. I almost DNF'd it, but I didn't because I wanted to finish it. It was just a really big letdown for me. Really let me down for the genre. But I decided to give the genre a second chance. I fell in love with it. That leads me to my next question, which is number six, the biggest surprise. And I gotta say, my biggest surprise was reading A Court of Thorns and Roses, which is a fantasy type book, and I was addicted. I fell in love with it, and I was just so surprised because I was just like, you know, I've seen a lot of you guys, you know, raving about this book and saying that it is so good, but you know, at the end of the day, you have to go in with your own, you know, with a clean slate, your own mindset, and just take it as it comes, you know? But everybody was ranting and raving about how A Court of Thorns and Roses was really good. But at the same time, I got those same thoughts from Carry On as well. Like, a lot of people were saying Carry On was really good, and I didn't like it. So I went in there not expecting anything. I went into reading A Court of Thorns and Roses with no expectations, zero expectations, and I fell in in love with it. And I think that's kind of the secret. You gotta go in with a clean slate, no expectations, and just take the book as it comes. Favorite new author. Now, this is a good one because my favorite, you know, famous author is Adam Silvera. Like, he's a new author that I discovered this year, and he is amazing. Like, I love his books. And I also started reading some independent authors' works as well. So Adam Silvera is the mainstream, but as far as independent authors, I like Jeff Lane. He actually wrote a book called One Way, which was really, really good. Sean McMahon, who actually wrote a book called Fur Lodge. That one was absolutely nuts. As well as Matthew Lation. He wrote Jack the Ripper Live and Uncut. OMG. All three of those books were absolutely nuts. Really kept me attached to the book. I didn't want to put it down, any of them down. And I love books like that. So guys, check out those three books. They are nuts. 8 is my newest fictional crush. It would have to be Jess from the book Heartless by Marissa Meyer. Jess is just funny. He is charming. He's got kind of a teasing personality, and I think that is so awesome. So he's my new fictional crush, Jess. Newest favorite character is the next question, and I think that would be Feyre from A Court of Thorns and Roses. This girl went through so much, seen so much, and still persevered through everything. And that makes her one of my favorites. This girl is just like a rock star. Next is actually a book that made me cry. It would have to be Tuesdays with Mari. It's about a man, an old man, who's going through ALS. And just, you know, his body's dying. And in this book, he talks about life, love, marriage, all of these different values. He was a 78-year-old man. So he was just pretty much delivering his wisdom. He was a sociology professor. And just hearing the bond that he had with the author, just, it crushed me. I was just like crying and stuff. Like, that book was good. It's called Tuesdays with Mari. You guys, if you want something that you're gonna learn from, and it's also considered nonfiction, it's really good, get it. Next is a book that made me happy. And I'll have to say that book, which was really fun to read, it has to be The Hating Game by Sally Thorne. Favorite film to book adaptation you saw this year? And I don't know about film to book, I know about book to film. I don't think I've seen any book to film adaptations this year. But I would have to say it would be Harry Potter, which is pretty much a book to film. Yeah. Number 13 is the favorite video I have done. And you know, these videos that I've done, I have just a few that I like, but I am really trying to improve the way I review books. And I gotta say, my favorites are two that I reviewed. One was One Way by Jeff Lane. The other was Fur Lodge by Sean McMahon. That's really just me trying to learn how to review books, as well as share with you why I enjoyed these books so much. So check them out. There's some reviews there on my YouTube page. Number 14 is, I have to read it because it's kind of long. The most beautiful book you bought so far this year or received. I gotta say, a book that I received that I thought was just such a beautiful cover, and oh my goodness, let me show this to you guys. Okay, the most beautiful cover book that I think I own in my library has to be this baby right here. I don't know if the camera is doing this book any justice, but it is so colorful. It pretty much tells, you know, a bit of the story through the picture on the cover. I know they say don't judge a book by its cover, but you see, it's kind of like beat up because I didn't put this book down. But oh my goodness, it's the Jack the Ripper Live and Uncut. This is such a beautiful cover. It's about a guy that he goes back in time to solve the Jack the Ripper murders, and it's really cool, guys. 15 is, what books do you need to read by the end of the year? So I do want to finish the Harry Potter books, at least get halfway through the series. I do want to read the Stephenie Meyer books, Cinder. I want to read that, as well as I want to go through a court, the Court of Mist and Fury series as well. I want to read An Abundance of Catherines. I do want to read Something in the Water, and there's a whole bunch more. You can find me on Goodreads and you'll see what my TBR pile kind of looks like. I mean, everything that I want to read is not on that list. I'm going to work on putting it there, but yeah. So there you have it, guys. I hope you enjoyed my mid-year freakout video. I was really excited to do it. I want to thank Libri Labra for tagging me, and I'm going to tag some of you guys below and to see how you do doing the mid-year freakout if you haven't done it already. And if you consider yourself a bookworm, book lover, book addict, book geek, any of those bookish terms, feed your need now by subscribing for more bookish videos. Take care, guys.